Welcome to the how-to video for CMG's Amazon Cloud solution. In this video, I'll be showing you how you can submit jobs directly to Amazon Cloud from our application. Firstly, the user will need to go onto this website and register for an account. Once this is approved, the user will be sent another link to log on to the website. I will log on using my credentials. After logging on, the user can see all the jobs that have been submitted and the files downloaded in the activity timeline. Or you can also go to the job list to see all the jobs that were run. If you click on Submit Jobs, you can actually submit jobs directly from this website. The interface is very similar to the app, so you can just select the file and fill out all the other details to submit the job. In this case, I'll be submitting the job from the desktop application, so I won't specify anything here. Lastly, in the settings section, you can do things such as change your password or activate the MFA token to add additional security. If you activate this option, you will need to specify a 6-digit code in addition to your password when you log in. This code will change every 30 seconds and will require the installation of Google's Authenticator app. Of course, from the website, there is an option to download the desktop app for AWS. I can now open up the app and log in. In this case, I have my password information already saved. If I had the MFA token enabled, I would have to specify that as well. This view is pretty similar to the previous versions of the app. To submit a job, you can either drag and drop the file onto this window or manually click this option and select Submit New Dataset. If you have multiple files, it's much easier to drag and drop instead of doing it one at a time. Currently, the maximum number of files you can submit like this is 10. In the Submit Dataset window, I can select my .dat file. And as you can see, this application will scan my .dat file and find names of include files, restart files, and so on, and automatically load them onto the window so I do not have to manually go and select them. The next thing to do is to select the data center. There are data centers located all over the world, and the client will get access only to the data center in the region they are located. Next, the user has to select the compute node. The compute node will affect the speed of the simulation. Half is fast, full is faster, and mega is fastest. So the option will come down to the size of the simulation and the runtime you're looking for. Next, I'll select the simulator version. The latest version of the software is always updated on the cloud, so you will always have access to the latest features. The rest of the options are pretty straightforward, just as you see in Launcher, so I will click OK and submit the run. When the job is submitted, all the files will get zipped up, encrypted, and uploaded to the cloud. From there, they will be submitted onto a compute node. As you can see, the job has been uploaded and is being prepared to be submitted. If this is the first job being submitted, AWS has to turn a compute node on, which takes about 10 minutes. After the initial warm-up period, the subsequent jobs will be submitted very quickly. The machine will stay on for 1 hour after the job is complete and will then turn off automatically. As you can see, the job is now running. I can right-click and view the log file. Now that the run is going, I can also download the results during the run. I can expand on the job and download the SR3 once I've set the download folder. This will send a signal to the simulator to pause the job so that the cloud service can grab the SR3, encrypt and zip it up and download it to the local computer. The simulator is paused only for a second or less. The file is now downloaded. I can load it up in results to view the plots. Now, if I wanted to update these results, all I have to do is download the results again from cloud, and once it's downloaded, I can hit the Reread Now option in results to update the plots. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us or check out our website. Thank you for watching.